I'm Prabhakar Hampivali, Professor and Head of Department of KLS, Google Institute of Technology, Belagavi. We are in the lecture number 7 now, 18-11, Module 3. I'm dealing with integral calculus. Since the lag structure, we are observing change of order concept in double integration. So here is on the screen, I think you are witnessing one example I have written. This may be the fourth example we are doing. So the given order is first y, then x. You can very easily note that. And we have to change the order, but before changing the order, we have to draw the figure. That is very important. So for that, whenever you are given this example, first write given limits. Listen it carefully, given limits. Whenever it is x, its opposite is y, it is the limit of y. So first is y is varying from y equal to 0 to y equal to square root of 1 minus x square. And x is varying from, when y is over here, x is varying from 0 to 1. That means given limits I equal to x 0 to 1, y 0 to square root of 1 minus x square, whatever the stuff inside y square. First is y, then is x. Should not see this order, please. You should see the order of limits given. That is very important. This is x means it is the limit of y, means you have to integrate with respect to y first. Now, before we proceed, as I told, you have to draw the region of integration, that is the figures. So, for that reason, I will rearrange algebraically this stuff. So, this is equivalent to y equal to 0 means x axis, and this is nothing but y square equal to squaring it 1 minus x square. So you have to get used to this minus x square this side, x square plus y square equal to 1. So you should become familiar, many of you are familiar, but those who are not familiar, y equal to 0 means x axis, x square plus y square equal to 1 means y axis. So these are the limits of y limits over. Now, x limits as it is, I write 0 to 1, x equal to 0 means y axis, x equal to 1 is a line parallel to y axis. Here we are ready to draw the figure. So, once we draw this coordinate axis, so all of us are very much used to x square plus y square equal to 1. And x equal to 0 is this straight line, y axis. Y equal to 0 is this x axis. So x equal to 1 is parallel to this y axis. This is the line x equal to 1 parallel to y axis. So that these four boundaries, where it is point boundary here, in this first of all, they have considered y limits means parallel to y axis, this strip is considered. You can see now y is varying from 0 to y to circle. This circle is y equal to square root of 1 minus x square. Or you can interchange x and y, x equal to square root of 1 minus y square is also true. Now, if at all I want to change the limit, instead of parallel limit to y-axis, parallel strip to x-axis, you have to consider. So, this is parallel to x-axis. So, that gives us limits for x first, which is x equal to this y-axis. X equal to 0 to x equal to, you should not consider line. X equal to varying limit, which is circle. So, x equal to 0 to x equal to square root of 1 minus y square. That you get by simplifying the same thing. You can interchange x and y here, x square equal to 1 minus y square, and so on. So this strip you have to vary from minimum point to maximum point. Minimum is 0 and maximum is 1 because radius is 1. So changing the order of integration x is varying from 0 to the circle, y axis to circle, and y is varying from minimum to maximum, y equal to 0 to y equal to 1. Now we are ready for the integration. After changing the order of integration, it looks like this now. I equal to first x 0 to square root 1 minus y square, y 0 to 1, and the integrand given was y square. So first with respect to x and then with respect to y. So let us integrate first with respect to x, integrating with respect to x, keeping y equal to constant. So I equal to y as it is, this y square as it is, dy as it is. So no y we are touching. Dx integration becomes x. Limits are 0 to square root of 1 minus y square, upper limit minus lower limit y square. Upper limit is wherever x is there, put upper limit. This whole thing you put here. Wherever x is there, you put here. So now, ordinary integration, but let us see this, how we integrate. If it is 1, it should be 1 here. If it is 2, it should be 4 here. If it is 3, it should be 9. If it is a, it should be a square. And that time, y equal to sine theta. If it is 2 here, 2 sine theta. 3 here, 3 sine theta. Dy equal to cos theta d theta. Naturally, when limits you are changing, when you put y equal to 0, sin theta 0, theta equal to 0. When you put y equal to 1, sin theta equal to 1, theta equal to pi by 2. So 0 to 1 changes to 0 to pi by 2. So hence we are in a simpler position of y language. For time being, we change to theta language. Theta 0 to pi by 2. Wherever y is there, sin theta. Sin theta whole square. This is y square. Y square 1 minus sin theta whole square dy. So this is nothing but 1 minus sin square is cos square. Square root of that, is cos theta. Hence, and instead of dy, sorry, you should write cos theta d theta. So this becomes 0 to pi by 2, interestingly, sin square theta. This is also cos theta. This is also cos theta, cos square theta d theta. Now before I go to this, some integration hints. Suppose 0 to pi by 2 is there. For both combination of sine and cos is there. For time being, I take both the powers even. That time, 8 you make it 1 less and write all the odd numbers. 6 you make it 5 and write all the odd numbers. Add these two, 14, and go on writing all the even numbers. If both are even, multiply by pi by 2. If both are not even, you have to multiply by 1. Now, in this case, what is happening? In this case, what is happening? Both are even. So, if both are odd, or if both are not odd, any other combination than even, even. Like one can be even, one can be odd, both can be odd. Suppose it can be 7 here and it can be some 9, or suppose I take 8 only. Same method but multiply by 1. 7 you make it 6, 6 equal to 8 you make it 7, 7 5 3. Add them, 7 5 3 1. Add them, 15. Till 1 you should go on writing, 15, 11 till 3 1, and multiply by 1 here at last. Here we come now. Final answer for this. 2 you make it 1, that's all. 2 you make it 1, that's all. And 2 plus 2 is 4. 4 into 2, that's all, into pi by 2. So naturally pi by 16 is the answer. Pi by 16 is the answer. Now, change of order, note it. Why we do this change of order? Change of order sometimes makes difficult to easy, impossible to possible. That is important. So here we go for the next example to witness this. Example number 2. Change the order of integration. Then hence evaluate. Double integration. The limits are 0 to infinity. Interesting now. X to infinity, the moment I write x here, it should be limit of y, that should click to your mind. E raised to minus y upon y dy. Without changing the order, now you cannot integrate this. Impossible. Otherwise, you have to use the Maclaurin series of e raised to minus y. But interesting area of integration, region of integration you have to draw. As usual, this is given is a limit. First is for y equal to x to y equal to infinity. Naturally, second in one is for x. And whatever the stuff of infinity is inside. First one is for definitely y. Second one is for x. First, with respect to y, you cannot integrate. Hence, what is y equal to x? All of us know. I am drawing the region. So, limits are y equal to x means a straight line. Now, y equal to 0, y equal to 1, y equal to 2, y equal to 3, y equal to 4. So, it is up. It is a parallel to y equal to 0, y equal to 1, some y equal to 2, and in the infinite position, some parallel line is there. Now, you will see that this this is a quadrant which is 1/4 of this whole quadrant is 1/4 of the whole quadrant system. In that half, 1/8 upper part of first quadrant you will get let us see how it is. So y equal to x already you have drawn, y equal to infinity is observed, x equal to 0 means this part boundaries I am drawing, x equal to 0 means this part, x equal to 0, x equal to 1, x equal to 2, x equal to 3, x equal to infinity. So you have to imagine that. So that region of integration becomes this part. Now whatever is given, so up to infinity it is. So whatever is given now, limits, it is varying according to y. So the strip is parallel to y-axis. Can you see this? Minimum y is this, because this is the boundary, this yellow color shade is the region of integration. Minimum y is this line y equal to x which is here. Maximum y is up to infinity, it is going parallel to y-axis. Now don't want first as limit of y. So consider parallel to x-axis, which is x equal to 0 to this line, x equal to 0 to x equal to y. So this becomes the first limit. And this strip should vary. So if it comes here, smaller it becomes. If it comes here, still smaller. Like that, if it comes here, still smaller, x equal to 0 to, it is becoming wider and wider. So when it goes to up to infinity, if you brush like this, it should cover the entire infinite region here. Infinite region it should cover. So that I am ready to write the change of order now. Changing order of integration by considering, in the previous example I have not written this, please you can write, considering strip parallel to x-axis now, I equal to first x equal to y-axis, that is 0 to this line, x equal to 0 to x equal to y. Very strange thing happens, y gets cancelled in the integration, that is very, very important. This is a very beautiful, beautiful example to demonstrate why change of order is necessary. Please make it a note, why this change of order is necessary, again and again I am telling. So then y equal to not 0 to 1 and all that, y equal to 0 to infinity is there. See this, up to infinite region it is. Integrand will not change, but order is dx dy now. First let us integrate with respect to y. First let us integrate with respect to y, with respect to x. Integrate with respect to x, naturally keeping y constant, I equal to y equal to constant, again and again you should tell y equal to 0 to infinity as it is, dy as it is, no touching of y. Okay, y is constant means e raised to minus y by y is also constant. Only dx becomes x, integration of dx becomes x between 0 to y, x equal to 0, wherever x is there you are putting. That means upper limit minus lower limit, when I substitute e raised to minus y by y as it is, dy as it is. Upper limit is wherever x is there, you put y, minus wherever x is there, you put 0. See, now this is the idea that these two y's are getting cancelled. If you don't change the order, they will not get cancelled and you can't integrate. Amazingly, it becomes a very simple integration, e raised to minus y. All of you know that e raised to 2y integration is e raised to 2y by 2. E raised to 3y integration is e raised to 3y by 3. E raised to minus 1y integration is e raised to minus 1y by minus 1, y equal to 0 to infinity. So upper limit is infinity minus lower limit is, minus lower limit is 0. E raised to minus infinity minus e raised to minus 0 divided by minus 1. So final answer of y, final answer of this integration. So we shall note that e raised to minus infinity means it is 1 upon e raised to infinity, means it is 1 upon infinity, means this tends to 0. So this becomes 0, which is I equal to 0 minus e raised to minus 0 is same thing as e raised to 0, which is 1. Fantastic answer, it is 1. Actually, such type of functions are known as probability functions. The integration which give the final answer as 1, they are probability functions. There is a special name to it. Sine functions, cos functions, trigonometric functions, exponential functions. Probability functions are those functions, after integrating, the value becomes 1. Interesting. So in the fourth semester, you will be learning the probability chapters. That time, you will be doing this integration and probability becomes 1. Then you cannot tell that. One more example of the same category, integrate, change the order, and hence integrate. I will not write the complete question, change the order. So your integration is again, now these two are infinity categories, 0 to infinity, x to infinity, to x, little bit variation, that's all. X into e raised to minus x square by y, dy, dx, or whatever you write. Naturally, the first limit is solution part. When I write, first you assign the limits, given limits, whatever is there. If it is x, it will be limit of y. Then remains is x. That means first you have to integrate with respect to y. Don't see the order, you have to see this. You have to see the order when it is constant integrations, limits are constants. Now, first y, then x. Whatever the stuff is given, please write integrand we call. Now, in order to change this limits of integration dy dx to dx dy, you have to draw these lines. What is y equal to 0? This is y equal to 0. What is y equal to x? This is y equal to x. What is x equal to 0? So that I am drawing one by one and marking them. I am drawing one by one and marking them. Now, whether it is here or here, it is a problem. Usually that becomes a problem where instead of this, they will consider this or vice versa. Now, carefully, x equal to 0 to infinity. X is here, 0. And to infinity. So, x equal to 1, x equal to 2, x equal to 3, x equal to 4. So, x equal to 0 to infinity. So, whether it is this side or this side. So, suppose if I mark this side. Suppose if I mark this side. What happens if I take a consider a strip parallel to y axis? And y equal to x to y equal to infinity becomes the region. Limits. Y equal to x to y equal to infinity. So, that is not correct. So, this is not correct. So, if I take the strip parallel to y axis here. Then see the lower limit is y equal to 0, upper limit is this line y equal to x. So that matches with what we have. The same would have been x to infinity, then you would have taken here. Okay. So this is x to infinity part, this is a 0 to x part. So that 0 to x to infinity. This part now, so that I am marking for you, this is the region of integration. And lower limit and upper limit are marked. This strip should vary from minimum of x. So maximum of x is infinity, that is here. Now we don't want this strip, we want horizontal strip which is x equal to y to infinity and y equal to 0 to infinity naturally. Because last limit should be constant, never forget taking strip parallel to y axis instead of first is first given was this, don't want this. Now we want to have minimum of this line to maximum is x equal to infinity. So now changing the order of integration, changing the order of integration, considering the strip. Parallel to x axis now, I equal to first x line to infinity, then y minimum to maximum, whatever stuff is there inside you write it. First x then y. So, dy dx has been changed to dx dy. Now, again when I fall into integration, first we shall write integrating with respect to x. Integrating, this is a y means it is something like x into e raised to minus x square by 4, because timing y is constant. Integrating with respect to x, keeping y constant. So now, to do that, first I will put x square equal to t, then 2x dx equal to dt or x dx equal to dt by 2, wherever x dx is there, I will put dt by 2. Let me write the limits as, t1 to t2, why I will tell you, instead of writing the limits in terms of t. So now, time being, x will be in terms of t, the y is not changing, x dx, I am writing dt by 2, e raised to minus t by 4 means y. So, that we integrate now, equal to, this is x equal to t equal to some t1 to t equal to t2 say, y equal to 0 to infinity, we are not worried about t1, t2 and t, time being we use t, when the integration is over, we get back to x and same limits of x, y to infinity you can take. So that when I integrate e raised to minus t by 4 suppose, then how would I integrate? Integration is same as this, divided by differentiation of this is minus 1 by 4. Instead of 4 you should write y, e raised to minus t by y, divided by minus 1 by y, t1 to t2. So work of t is over now, it is a dummy variable, in between helpful variable, just for the help it has come in between. Now going back to x, this looks like y, don't touch it. So minus of y, don't touch it, dy, don't touch it, e raised to minus t was x square, x limit was, do you remember the value of x limit? Okay, let me show you that. So we change this limit, x limit afterwards was y to infinity. So that back I am putting here, instead of t1, t2, x limits backed y to infinity. Now it is ready for limits, substituting the limits. Minus y equal to 0 to infinity as it is, y as it is, dy as it is, infinity, wherever x is there, don't touch y, wherever x is there, put infinity, e raised to minus infinity divided by constant, e raised to minus infinity, minus y square, you have to put e raised to minus y square upon y, wherever x is there, y you are putting, dy remains as it is. Now, equal to minus 0 to infinity, y, e raised to minus infinity is 0, minus e raised to minus y, dy, minus as it is, minus of minus plus, y into e raised to minus y, usually we do by integration by parts, let me do it by integration by parts, y into e raised to minus y by minus 1, minus 1 into e raised to minus y by minus 1 once again. What we did here actually is, I'll tell you, we consider this y, first keep as it is, go on differentiating. Suppose y square is there, y square 2y2, okay, and go on integrating this, e raised to minus y by minus 1, e raised to minus y by minus 1 whole square, every time this minus 1 will come out. For example, e raised to 2y, suppose y square is there, how I integrate? Y square 2y, 2 become differentiation part, e raised to 2y by 2, e raised to 2y by 4, e raised to 2y by 8. Alternatively, plus, minus, plus signs, y square 2y, 2, e raised to 2y by 2, every time one 2 extra, 2y by 4, 2y by 8. This is just for demonstration I took. So now, integration is over y equal to 0 to infinity. So detailed proof I am not giving, whenever it is infinity, it is becoming 0, that much I will tell you, so that some people may have doubt because here infinity is there. So now, because if you expand in Maclaurin series, you will get the 0 answer. So when I put infinity, upper limit is 0, minus when I put 0, y equal to 0 is 0 here. So minus of, this is 1, e raised to 0. So we'll check whether it is 1 or half. I think somewhere we have missed this half. Let us see, very interesting it is. This dt by 2 I had written, I think that half here. Sorry. It's a 2. This 2 half goes on remaining everywhere. Please correct it. Half everywhere. Sometimes it becomes nice that we are correcting afterwards. everywhere half. So that final answer is half into. So answer is half. So if at all you want to convert into probability, you multiply the given function to 2 by 2. So these are the fantastic examples of change of order. Starting from constant integrations, you should go from first, and there is one more type of integration which I will tell you, change of variables only. So what do we mean by change of variables? Let us use our previous knowledge. For example, this demo I will give you, suppose we were given to integrate I equal to 0 to 1 x raised to 4 square root of 1 minus x square. So then I change a variable x to theta, because in terms of theta the work becomes simple. Just changing the language, something like English to Germany or Germany to English. So now if I change a language x to theta by some connector, sine, cos, whatever you want, 1 by theta. So then without wasting much time, it gets connected to, instead of x equal to 0 to 1, it becomes theta equal to 0 to pi by 2, because we don't want to spend time here. Sine raised to 4 theta, and this becomes cos theta, cos square theta d theta. And the work is done very easily, because 3, 1, 1, and here 6, 4, 2 by pi by 2, answer becomes here also 1 by 2 pi by 32. So here sum and substance is variable x to theta is changed. Yes, very similar, but when you changed x to theta, dx you did not write d theta. Dx you wrote cos theta d theta, because x equal to sin theta, dx is cos theta d theta. But what was this cos theta? This cos theta is nothing but differentiation of first variable. Differentiation of first variable with respect to second variable, dx by d theta only. It is a simple mathematics. Multiply by d theta, divide by d theta. Similar things happen in two variables now. So I will take example and demonstrate it. Now we change Cartesian to polar coordinates, which is a very standard one. If you have done engineering and if you have learnt double integration, if you have not heard of r theta xy plane, whenever here elementary area is there, this becomes dx dy, and whenever the similar type of elementary area is there here, because elementary area is taken by strips parallel to y axis, strip parallel to x axis, intersection gives this part, and here actually theta plus d theta, r plus dr, this becomes the elementary area, and these two cannot be equal. I cannot write this as dr d theta. Naturally dx dy cannot be dr d theta. It will be change of xy with respect to r theta . This is Jacobian. So what is the multiplier you require? You require multiplier. We cannot write dx dy equal to differentiation of xy with respect to differentiation of r theta. So if I write like this, it is nothing but Jacobian, okay, into dr d theta. So now this is nothing but standard value r. Whenever we are changing Cartesian to polar, multiplicative element is r. So that you keep in mind, and here we have got fantastic examples. After changing to change of order, now important examples, change to polar coordinates, that is xy to r theta, please, that you should see. After changing, no xy should remain. Change to polar coordinates. And hence integrate. Some example we shall consider, 0 to 1 0 to square root of y equal to x2 y equal to instead of this 0 to instead of 1 I'll change to infinity, and this also I'll make it 0 to infinity e raised to minus of x square plus y square dx dy. Here also interestingly, either it is impossible or difficult, and that makes very very simple. Sometimes variable limits get converted to constant limits. Again, I am telling utility is, why we should do is, utility is almost difficult or impossible make simple or possible. Variable limits get converted to constant limits. Double advantage many times. So now let us see. So region of integration here also is easy. So to substitute, we have to substitute x is r cos theta, y is r sin theta. This you have done many times, because whenever there is a overlap of Cartesian and polar, so this is our x, this is our y, this is our r, which is square root of x square plus y square. This is not important, theta. So x by r is cos theta, trigonometry. So x by r is cos theta, and x by y by r is sin theta. dx dy is r dr t theta. So this is always there. This is always there in all change of coordinates, polar to Cartesian to polar. This stuff is common to all the examples. Changing from Cartesian to polar, it is common. Cartesian to polar, it is common. So now, region of integration. X is positive. X equal to 0 to infinity means x is positive. Y equal to 0 to infinity means y is positive. Both are positive means it is the first quadrant. To cover the first quadrant, what you have to do? You have to consider a strip parallel to, I mean here this is the strip actually, which is like this, it appears in the polar coordinates. So if I am moving this from minimum to maximum, this becomes 0 to infinity. This is r, this r value. So this is r equal to 0 to infinity, because you have to cover the entire region. And this, suppose this is a torch-like structure, you vary it from here to move like this to cover. So here to here means angle of rotation is theta equal to 0 to pi by 2. So hence, once again I am telling, first consider the strip like this. Once again I am drawing for you the same figure. Once again I am drawing for you. Okay. No doubt both x and y are 0 to infinity positive means this becomes, first quadrant becomes region of integration. I considered a elementary area of this fashion, which is our r dr d theta. And if I vary it minimum to maximum of r, minimum r value is 0. Here suppose 1, here 2, here 3, up to infinity. R equal to 0 to r equal to infinity. So that time this strip is created. This focus beams like strip is created. So this you have to vary from minimum and move like this. This you move like this, which is, suppose if it is here, it looks like this. Suppose this is a torch-like structure, just to make you understand. And if it comes here and touches this, it moves here. So this is theta equal to 0 to theta equal to pi by 2. Fantastic. Now, ready for first convert into polar coordinates. Once again I am writing I equal to 0 to infinity, 0 to infinity, both x and y were given. E raised to minus of x square plus y square was given. Never forget, throughout this small chapter, x square plus y square equal to r square. Dx dy is there. Now it is not change of order, it is change of variables. After conversion, only r theta should remain. So r equal to 0 to infinity, theta equal to 0 to pi by 2, e raised to minus r square, r dr d theta. So first, you can integrate with respect to theta also, you can integrate with respect to r also, because constant limits are there, you can separate out. First, I'll integrate with respect to r. For that, I'll put r square equal to t. R dr equal to, that is 2 R dr equal to dt. R dr equal to dt by 2. So, t equal to R equal to 0, t equal to 0. R equal to infinity, t equal to infinity. So, R 0 to infinity implies t also 0 to infinity. Here no problem, directly I can write t equal to 0 to infinity. So, this becomes e raised to minus t. R dr is dt by 2, I am substituting that. So, now theta as it is, d theta as it is, e raised to half outside, e raised to minus t integration. I equal to half in theta equal to 0 to pi by 2. Upper limit e raised to minus 0 minus lower limit e raised to 0 divided by minus 1. Upper limit infinity. So that this value is also minus 1. Half. So 1 d theta, which is half theta between 0 to pi by 2. Fantastic. Half pi by 2 minus 0. Final answer is pi by 4. So, here is the first example we did. So, very similarly, let us observe one more example. So, all are change to polar coordinates. Change to polar coordinates. Suppose integration is minus a2 plus a and this example we will continue the next which I will write. You try minus a2 plus a square root of 0 to square root of a square minus x square. Root of x square plus y square dy dx. Information is answer is pi a cube by 3. You try, otherwise the next class, class number 8, we will do these examples and move on to the very fantastic applications of all these. But before that, there is a very nice chapter known as beta gamma functions. We will move to that also. Till that, bye for the lecture number 7. So nice. Take care. Bye bye. ಹತ್ತು ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಅಂದ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಅದು ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಆಗಿದೆಯಲ್ಲ. ಅಯ್ಯೋ, ನಾ ಬಂದ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ನೇನು ಇದನ್ನ.